Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received this comment from my viewer. How do I adjust SMPS output voltage that dropped from 12 to 11? And we want to bring it back to 12 volts. First of all, we will see an example. What are the possible reasons for the voltage drop? The possible reasons, if we don't have any fluctuation in the output, might be our feedback network that have some problem. Where is the feedback network? Feedback network, it is a optocoupler, TL431 voltage regulator, or zener reference, and a voltage divider network that is connected between the positive and negative output, positive and the return output. Two resistors which are connected to TL431 pin number 1, that is reference pin. If you see feedback network, here we have some resistor, that is current limit resistor, and optocoupler LED, and we have TL431 and ground. It is a zener regulator, but its voltage can be adjusted at per our requirement. For that purpose, pin number 1 is used as a reference pin. Pin 2 is ground, pin 3 is output. This is our TL431. Where is that? That is connected in the output side. It works as a sensor. And here we have one resistor, two resistors. These two resistors are voltage divider network. When the voltage will reach here 2.5 volt, at that time it will allow to flow the current from this LED. What is that LED? That is optocoupler here. And its output transistor will switch and it will control the PWM controller. If we have some problem that the voltage are dropped due to any reason, what are that possible reasons? Check the soldering of MOSFET. Check the soldering of the transformer primary winding. If we have bent joint here in the transformer winding primary side, or in the MOSFET that is in the primary side with the main DC capacitor, bulk capacitor, it can also increase the resistance. Bad joint, when there is a bad joint or dry soldering, it will increase the contact resistance. So the current will reduce in the primary, which will cause to reduction in the voltage in the secondary. Then secondary winding joints, check them out, desolder it and resolder it again. Output rectifier. Then in some cases our output capacitor, it becomes bad. That will cause to reduction in the voltage. If you don't have fluctuation and voltage are dropped, in that case might be some component here, it have reduced its value, that is devalued. What are that components? This resistor. If its resistance value is decreased at that time, it will allow early switching between its allowed level. So that will cause to reduce the voltage level. For that purpose, we can remove this resistance. We will measure this resistance and we can add some more resistance to increase the voltage. What will happen? We will increase this resistance, so more voltage will drop here and here the voltage will decrease. When it will decrease, it will take some more time to increase the voltage. For that purpose, if it is 10k, for example, we can use 10k plus 1k or 2k potentiometer in series of this resistor. We can see this example. Here we have 27 kilo ohm resistor and 3.3 kilo ohm resistor and a potentiometer. This potentiometer will allow to adjust the voltage. If we check this power supply, if this power supply is designed to provide 12 volt, I must not exceed from its design. For example, if it is 12 volt, okay, I can take 12, 12.5, 13 volt, and if I will try to take more voltage at that time, we will damage this power supply. The first problem, it will not handle the load properly. The second thing, it will run in maximum duty cycle. So when we will put load, it will not handle the load properly and it will lose its regulation. Where are that resistors? If we check here, this is pin number 1 of TL431. This pin is ground, 2 number pin that is connected to this ground pin. This is our ground line. This is pin number 3, which is going to optocoupler. And optocoupler second end is connected to this resistor and it is connected to positive. And same one resistor here, it is connected to positive. Positive and pin number 1. And if we see here, we have one capacitor and one resistor here, it is connected to the ground side. So we have two resistors, 1, 2, and the third resistor. In some power supplies, here is just only one resistor, here it is using two resistors in series. We can remove this resistor, this one, and we can add one more resistor in series of this resistor to adjust the voltage. Connect one lead to the pin number 1, reference pin, and check here. So it is coming directly here, and then this resistor, it is 4 kilo ohm resistor, and this resistor and this resistor, these two are in series. It is 4.2k resistor because this is 297 ohm resistor. 1, 2, and this end is connected to ground. This is our ground line, and from this side to this side it is connected together, two resistors connected together, and from here to here it is connected to pin number 1, and pin number 1 is connected to this resistor and this is connected to positive. We can remove it and we can measure this resistance, and we will add one more resistance in series of this resistance. This SMD resistance is 20 kilo ohm resistance, and we will add one more resistance in series of this one, because in circuit it was giving 44.7k, but out of circuit it is 20 kilo ohm resistance. Now I am connecting two resistors in series, 10 kilo ohm and 10 kilo ohm, two resistors. Okay, now I will connect these two resistors to the same point. I will connect it to pin number 1 of TL431, and this we will connect to the positive. Now I connected this end to the positive and this end to the TL431 pin number 1 where this resistance was connected. Now we will connect the power supply. I will use series lamp to turn it on, and we will check the output voltage here. DC voltage, power supply is turned on now, it is 12.11 volt. Now let me add a variable resistance in series of these two. I will use 5 kilo ohm potentiometer in parallel, it will become 2.5 kilo ohm. And I will use just only 2 points I am using just only 1 and the 2 point, the third point I left open. Let's check the voltage now. . 12.12, we can adjust the voltage in this way. Now, a safety point. Don't increase too much output voltage so that the power supply must remain its specified limits. You can see 20 kilo ohm resistance. This time I added 21 and 2.5. So here we added some more resistance. We increased this resistance and the voltage level now increased. When we are using just only 20k resistor, which is the original resistance which we removed from this power supply, at that time it was 12.11, and when we added some more resistance, the voltage will increase. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.